Chapter 5. Make your heart healthy and strong with these lifestyle changes. There comes a time in everyone's lives when we have to decide and commit to making healthy lifestyle changes. Oftentimes, it's when they realize that their body is starting to break down, in the terminal stage of a disease, or experience the pain of losing a loved one from ill health. These situations are often the turning point in their lives where they finally decide on the best course for them and their family. It's always better to live a healthy life, full of vitality, youth, and vibrancy than to live a sick life that constantly relies on health support. Our environment plays a significant role in our heart health. So if your living condition is not conducive to your health, such as living in a heavily polluted area with poor hygiene and health facilities, the best option is to relocate to somewhere else. Diet. The importance of a healthy diet. Our bodies and hearts form an extremely complex organic living machine, but far more advanced than anything a man can create. But like all machines, it needs the right fuel and lubrication to maintain it. Have you heard of the saying that your body is your vehicle for this life's journey? Thus, you should honor your body more than anything else. Think about it. Would you put cheap vegetable oil in your new car or try and fill the tank with cheap, dirty old fuel? Then why would you do that to your body? You can always buy a new car, but you cannot get a new body. Well, maybe a new heart, but what a hassle and expense. Surely it is sensible to only use the very best fuels for your body. Of course, what I meant by fuel is your diet intake. Only choose the food that'll benefit your health, not destroy your body. Exercise. The best heart exercises. So what is the best and most effective exercise for preventing heart diseases? Studies show that high-intensity exercise coupled with slightly longer periods of active recovery is not only beneficial to your heart's health, but also aids in weight loss, diabetes, and improving your overall fitness level. It can be done by walking for 3 minutes at your normal speed and then walking 1 minute at a brisk pace. By raising and lowering your heart rate continuously through simple high-intensity workouts, you can have a better vascular function, burn more calories, and also enhance the body's detoxification functions. Another excellent exercise for your heart is a total body, non-impact sport such as tennis or squash, swimming or rowing, taekwondo or other martial arts. All of these involve the use of many different muscles, so give your body a good workout without overtaxing any one area, but making your heart work hard to supply them all. You can also create your own ideal workout that fits your current fitness level by incorporating slow intervals. Core workouts such as push-ups and squats help to strengthen the core muscles, providing your body a good foundation. People who are active all day long are generally healthier than those who exercise 30 minutes to an hour a day and live a sedentary lifestyle for the rest of the day. But bear in mind that not all exercises are good for the body. For instance, jogging or running on hard surfaces for a long distance is probably the worst types of exercise, although they do strengthen the heart. It's because such endurance type exercises wear the body out quickly and strain your joints in the long term, especially if you don't have a pair or comfortable shoes or proper running techniques. Equally, it is not advisable to perform any exercise that you have not trained or warmed up for. Doing so will only result in unwanted injuries and even trigger a heart attack due to adrenaline surge. If you have an exercise routine that you enjoy, then follow it and improve it by adding to it, rather than changing to something you may not enjoy. Stress reduction. Countless studies prove that psychological factors can contribute to heart disease and possible heart attacks. Anxiety, anger, depression, hostility, as well as social isolation can affect your heart attack risk factor. Workplace stress and financial stress can increase your risk of a heart attack by 50%. After the 9/11/2001 terrorist attacks, it was found people who felt high levels of stress just after the attack were twice as likely to develop high blood pressure and had a threefold chance of developing heart disease over the following 2 years. Similar results have been observed after large earthquakes and other natural disasters. Environmental conditions, clean air and water. Water and air pollution are significant contributors to people developing heart disease and stroke. A stroke is like a heart attack to the brain. Staying indoor too often might not be as safe as you think because there's indoor air pollution. Pollution comes from a mixture of different contaminants such as fumes from household cleaning products, wood-burning stoves, and fireplaces, secondhand cigarette smoke, vapors from cleaning products, paint solvents, pesticides, insecticides and carbon monoxide. Exposure to low levels of CO, cardio monoxide, can cause a cardiovascular patient to have increased heart rhythm, chest pain, and irregularities that make it difficult to exercise. Indoor CO can come from inside furnaces, dryers, gas water heaters, space heaters, ranges, and fireplace and wood stoves. There is evidence that several minerals commonly found in drinking water may contribute to heart disease or aggravate its symptoms. Lead, arsenic, fluoride and chlorine exposure are all clearly associated with heart disease. Chapter 6, Healthy Heart Remedies. Many natural remedies use a variety of herbs and supplements to help treat as well as prevent heart disease. Atherosclerosis, the hardening of the arteries, is a common cause of heart disease. This disease is found mainly in the Western world. On the other hand, atherosclerosis is relatively rare in the Third World countries due to the difference in lifestyles, access to traditional diets and herb remedies. Most importantly, they're free from chemicals and toxins from the processed foods that can jeopardize the heart's health. Coenzyme Q10, or ubiquinone, is a compound that helps our cells extract energy from food. This compound is often missing from our diets. Although coenzyme Q10 is produced naturally in our body, the amount decreases dramatically as a person grows older or has reduced cholesterol levels. So by supplementing coenzyme Q10 in your daily stack, you can ensure that your body has an adequate supply of nutrients to sustain your heart and keep your cells healthy. If you are not getting enough magnesium and potassium in your diet, by taking these supplements can help you regulate your blood pressure levels as well as improve heart function. As you may or may not know, salt goes a long way back in the human's history. It plays a vital role in both the development of human civilization as well as public health politics in the past centuries. Although salt was highly regarded as a prized ingredient for thousands of years, it was demonized in the past century. Today, it was even named as one of the single most harmful substances in the human body. However, recent studies have shown that although the amount of salt intake affects the heart health, it still plays a significant role in a healthy heart and optimal health. In fact, too little salt can cause various diseases and harm your body in the long run. Thus, we should consume salt in moderation for better health. So where do we get our salt? Natural, unrefined sea or rock salt are a great source of minerals. Sea salt is the best source of salt that we can find to enrich our food with an abundance of minerals. Today, it's difficult to find a trace of healthy minerals in our food due to the shortage of nutrient-rich soil. So by adding a variety of sea salts to our food, we can obtain the much-needed minerals from the Earth's oceans. But not all salts are good for our health. In fact, table salt, which is mined from the salt deposits underground, is heavily processed and detrimental to our health. Processed table salt is stripped of its natural minerals and often includes additive to avoid clumping. You can only reap all the health benefits of the minerals from the ocean by choosing whole, natural sea salt that's worth its salt. Not to mention the incredible taste that it can bring to your best dishes. Fish oil and other supplements. Many supplements like fish oil are often of low quality and can be harmful. This is due to the extraction process used, which causes them to oxidize. It is important to access the quality before purchasing or taking any supplements. Typically, a good wholesome diet will supply all the needs of the body. The only time supplements become necessary is when your diet is lacking or when certain health conditions cause you to develop an insufficiency or deficiency. Most dietary supplements are safe, and some of them offer actual health benefits, but there can be some risk with their use. Some of these are also anti-nutrients. They prevent the body absorbing nutrients. Omega-3 fatty acids are essential nutrients that are found in naturally grown plants, free-range, naturally fed livestock and sea-caught fish. Usually, in nature, they are found in the ideal proportion for heart health of 50-50 with other natural fats such as omega-6 fats. Livestock such as eggs, dairy and seafood lack many essential nutrients when they are raised in feedlots or factory farms without natural feeds or natural sunshine. They lack omega-3 fats and contain very high amount of damaging fats, which is bad for health. So if you're not consuming free-range organic food, then you're highly recommended to include supplements in your diet to fulfill your daily nutritional needs. Vitamins and their importance. Health experts find that vitamin C is undoubtedly one of the safest and much-needed nutrients for the human body. By taking in a daily dose of vitamin C, your body will have a similar effect with walking. A simple exercise as walking can stimulate a protein known as endothelin-1, which induces the constriction of small blood vessels. Studies show that people who take a daily time-release dose of vitamin C at 500 mg can inhibit the endothelin-1 activity as much as those who walked regularly. Vitamin B9, also known as folic acid, is one of the water-soluble vitamins. It's one of the essential vitamins that you should include in your daily nutritional needs. Our liver acts as a storage for vitamins. On a daily basis, our body will utilize the required amount of vitamin from this storage. The excess amount of vitamins is then eliminated from our body automatically through the excretory system. Vitamin B9 aids in one of the most important functions of the body, which includes everything from the formation of red blood cells to the production of vital energy. Besides that, vitamin B9 also provides health benefits such as creating a defensive barrier from cancer, stroke, heart diseases, and birth anomalies. Other advantages include muscle building, hemoglobin formation, and also prevention from mental and emotional breakdowns. Vitamin B9 can be found naturally in asparagus, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and lentils. Enzymes in foods. Enzymes are vital for every cell in our body as they are organic, biological catalyst that starts, promote and speed up biochemical reactions. Metabolic enzymes in the blood break down the protein-based protection of virus parasites, bacteria and fungi. They are cleansers that combat chronic inflammation, preventing most diseases including heart disease. Our body produces many enzymes, millions a day, but we still need a good supply of fresh enzymes from fresh food. When you eat a healthy wholesome diet with plenty of raw, fresh fruits and vegetables, you get a good variety of enzymes and antioxidants as well as fiber. Antioxidants are molecules that give off electrons that help to maintain the integrity of your cells. Antioxidants help to prevent cholesterol from oxidizing. In fact, oxidized cholesterol is the reason of fatality. Although oxidation is one of the normal bodily processes, it can be life-threatening if there's an overproduction of oxidized cholesterol. Why is that so? It's because unlike the other products of oxidation, oxidized cholesterol is commonly mistaken as bacteria by our natural immune system. Thus, your body will do whatever it takes to eliminate oxidized cholesterol from the body, causing inflammation of the arterial walls. As a result, it can lead to atherosclerosis or even heart diseases. There are many recognized antioxidants, but the one of the most well-known is vitamin E. Study after study has shown that vitamin E is a potent antioxidant that can help prevent and even treat free radical damage. Factory farming versus organic foods. Have you heard of the term factory farming? It's a modern-day term that refers to the non-traditional approach to farming businesses that focuses on keeping animals at high stocking densities. They're able to achieve this goal by incorporating modern technology to hasten animal growth, increase production outputs, and reduces the death rate of livestock. The modern society, especially business owners and investors, share the same opinion that factory farming is the way to go for modern farming. Factory farming was also regarded as one of the top innovations and believed to solve countless issues, providing high production output and lowering the cost. On the other hand, there are also some who are against it, claiming that factory farming brings more harm than good to both our health and environment. Animal activists also protest against animal cruelty practices in factory farming. So what is the truth? After years of close monitoring and extensive studies in the agriculture sector, it is found that most factory farming utilize poor quality ingredients and questionable processing methods. On the other hand, there's an organic way of farming. This term refers to the more natural, less toxic approach on how the agricultural products are grown and produced. For instance, organic crops must be grown without the use of modern agricultural chemicals such as GMOs, bioengineered genes, synthetic pesticides, sewage sludge-based, and petroleum-based fertilizers. Organic livestock must not be injected with growth hormones, antibiotics, or animal byproducts. Organic livestock must be grown with organic feed and given access to roam outdoors. Any less than that cannot be labeled as organic. Thus, organic agricultural products are far more nutritional and less toxic to our body. Consuming more organic food and less factory farmed food can lead to better health with more retained nutrients. Detox. The real story: our bodies, if given the raw materials needed, are very good at detoxing themselves. People who have a healthy, wholesome diet and refrains from indulging in too many processed foods, a small amount of processed food is not ideal, but the body can deal with it if not overloaded, will enjoy renewed energy and heart health. Meditative cures, reflexology and mindfulness. Psychological risk factors including anxiety and depression are clearly factors that can have a substantial effect on the heart. Stress can affect and increase the risk factors for heart disease and high blood pressure, BP, especially if coupled with physical inactivity and a person being overweight. Based on the latest clinical findings, it is found that meditation can drastically reduce the risk of heart diseases, stroke, and even death by approximately 50%. They found that deep breathing and acute relaxation can be more effective than any latest super drugs to prevent or even cure heart diseases. The ultimate goal of meditation is to find balance within our body. Although this may sound intangible and hard to grasp by the majority of our society today, meditation has been proven to balance out our biomarkers in the body. These biomarkers are also known as hormones and neurotransmitter. When you're experiencing stress or pain from any part of the body, it's normally due to the hormonal changes and neurotransmitter imbalance. A powerful cure for this situation is meditation. This practice helped countless of patients to regulate their biomarkers. Why is meditation so powerful? The secret lies in the practice of mindfulness. Mindfulness is a term that refers to being able to focus your awareness on the present moment and everything around you, both internally and externally. One of the keys of mindfulness is to always be at the present moment. Being present to your thoughts, emotions, and behaviors without judging them. The practice of non-judgment is the essence of staying truly calm and present. The benefits of mindfulness are endless. Studies have demonstrated that people who practice mindfulness regularly are more likely to live longer, have healthier hearts, stronger immune system, and unlikely to be obese. Another alternative therapy for heart health is reflexology. This method appeals to those who seek for non-invasive therapy. In fact, some people might even find reflexology to be rather relaxing and therapeutic. It's not necessary to visit the reflexology centers to reap the benefits, as you can easily apply these self-relaxing techniques yourself at any time on your hands and feet, provided that you know how to do it properly. Reflexology helps to maintain the balance of the mind and body by keeping them in a homeostasis state, so that the body can function optimally. By applying pressure at certain pressure points of the body, trained reflexologists are able to fix the malfunctioned body and put your body in the natural equilibrium state. Applying pressure at certain pressure points are able to stimulate your muscles, tissues, and even cells of any parts of your body. These pressure points are also known as reflexes on the hands and feet. Different pressure points affect different parts of the body. In order to relax and invigorate the myocardial muscles, the pressure points are located on the reflexes on your feet, which also indirectly stimulates the colon and pituitary gland. Superfoods for heart health. There are a lot of foods that have the properties to dramatically help with heart health problems, mainly because they are very rich sources of the nutrients and compounds that naturally purify arteries, cleanse and remove inflammation, as well as boost the immune system. Avocados are very high in healthy fats, and if eaten regularly, their compounds are able to normalize and stabilize blood cholesterol levels, maintain clear arteries and eliminate clots. Asparagus has been found to be a very effective blood cleanser. It is able to reduce blood pressure and slow the forming of blood clots. It is loaded with vitamins B1, B2, C, E and K. Pomegranates have an impressive array of antioxidants that help to protect artery membranes, They also promote the production of nitric oxide that allows a person's blood to flow more freely through their blood vessels. Turmeric reduces inflammation and the hardening of the arteries, as well as helping to keep them clear and reduce blood clots. Persimmon is a very good source of polyphenols and antioxidants that both help to reduce bad cholesterol, LDL, and triglycerides. They also help to normalize blood pressure and cleanse the arteries. Spirulina helps to regulate blood fat levels, normalizes lipid levels, and contains necessary essential amino acids, which help to improve the immune system. Cinnamon is able to decrease harmful cholesterol levels and clean plaque, so it is unable to accumulate in the arteries and blood vessels. Broccoli helps to prevent calcium buildup in arteries and helps to reduce blood pressure and normalize cholesterol levels. Cranberries are thought to decrease the risk of developing heart disease in most people by up to 40%. They have a high antioxidant content, which helps to increase HDL while reducing LDL levels. Green tea contains a large amount of catechins, which help to decelerate the absorption of cholesterol and improve blood lipid levels, as they help to clear obstructions from arteries. Green tea also helps with cardiovascular health and enhances a person's metabolism. Conclusion. Thank you for purchasing this guidebook. I hope you enjoy this book and benefit immensely from it. As a general rule, our body's overall health starts with taking care of our heart. If you are looking after your heart, then you will also be looking after the rest of your body. The decisions that you make regarding your diet and lifestyle will ultimately affect your heart health, your overall well-being. Not just that, your family will also be affected. If you're following a diet that consists of mainly processed foods, you're putting poisons into your body with empty carbohydrates and chemicals. Plus, if you are inactive in most parts of the day and live a sedentary lifestyle, you can expect to have major health issues at some point in your life, and you'll ultimately reduce your lifespan. On the other hand, if you have a healthy lifestyle, take sensible precautions on your food intake, and are active in physical exercises, then you can expect to live a long, healthy life, free of heart problems and many other chronic health issues that plague most people. This will allow you to enjoy your golden years in relatively good health. Chapter 6, Healthy Heart Remedies. Many natural remedies use a variety of herbs and supplements to help treat as well as prevent heart disease. Atherosclerosis, the hardening of the arteries, is a common cause of heart disease. This disease is found mainly in the Western world. On the other hand, atherosclerosis is relatively rare in the third world countries due to the difference in lifestyles, access to traditional diets and herb remedies. Most importantly, they're free from chemicals and toxins from the processed foods that can jeopardize the heart's health. Coenzyme Q10, or ubiquinone, is a compound that helps our cells extract energy from food. This compound is often missing from our diets. Although coenzyme Q10 is produced naturally in our body, the amount decreases dramatically as a person grows older or has reduced cholesterol levels. So by supplementing coenzyme Q10 in your daily stack, you can ensure that your body has an adequate supply of nutrients to sustain your heart and keep your cells healthy. If you are not getting enough magnesium and potassium in your diet, by taking these supplements can help you regulate your blood pressure levels as well as improve heart function. As you may or may not know, salt goes a long way back in the human's history. It plays a vital role in both the development of human civilization as well as public health politics in the past centuries. Although salt was highly regarded as a prized ingredient for thousands of years, it was demonized in the past century. Today, it was even named as one of the single most harmful substances in the human body. However, recent studies have shown that although the amount of salt intake affects the heart health, it still plays a significant role in a healthy heart and optimal health. In fact, too little salt can cause various diseases and harm your body in the long run. Thus, we should consume salt in moderation for better health. So where do we get our salt? Natural, unrefined sea or rock salt are a great source of minerals. Sea salt is the best source of salt that we can find to enrich our food with an abundance of minerals. Today, it's difficult to find a trace of healthy minerals in our food due to the shortage of nutrient-rich soil. So by adding a variety of sea salts to our food, we can obtain the much-needed minerals from the Earth's oceans. But not all salts are good for our health. In fact, table salt, which is mined from the salt deposits underground, is heavily processed and detrimental to our health. Processed table salt is stripped of its natural minerals and often includes additive to avoid clumping. You can only reap all the health benefits of the minerals from the ocean by choosing whole, natural sea salt that's worth its salt. Not to mention the incredible taste that it can bring to your best dishes. Fish oil and other supplements. Many supplements like fish oil are often of low quality and can be harmful. This is due to the extraction process used, which causes them to oxidize. It is important to access the quality before purchasing or taking any supplements. Typically, a good wholesome diet will supply all the needs of the body. The only time supplements become necessary is when your diet is lacking or when certain health conditions cause you to develop an insufficiency or deficiency. Most dietary supplements are safe, and some of them offer actual health benefits, but there can be some risk with their use. Some of these are also anti-nutrients. They prevent the body absorbing nutrients. Omega-3 fatty acids are essential nutrients that are found in naturally grown plants, free-range, naturally fed livestock and sea-caught fish. Usually, in nature, they are found in the ideal proportion for heart health of 50-50 with other natural fats such as omega-6 fats. Livestock such as eggs, dairy and seafood lack many essential nutrients when they are raised in feedlots or factory farms without natural feeds or natural sunshine. They lack omega-3 fats and contain very high amount of damaging fats, which is bad for health. So if you are not consuming free-range organic food, then you're highly recommended to include supplements in your diet to fulfill your daily nutritional needs. Vitamins and their importance. Health experts find that vitamin C is undoubtedly one of the safest and much needed nutrients for the human body. By taking in a daily dose of vitamin C, your body will have a similar effect with walking. A simple exercise as walking can stimulate a protein known as endothelin-1, which induces the constriction of small blood vessels. Studies show that people who take a daily time-release dose of vitamin C at 500 mg can inhibit the endothelin-1 activity as much as those who walked regularly. Vitamin B9, also known as folic acid, is one of the water-soluble vitamins. It's one of the essential vitamins that you should include in your daily nutritional needs. Our liver acts as a storage for vitamins. On a daily basis, our body will utilize the required amount of vitamin from this storage. The excess amount of vitamins is then eliminated from our body automatically through the excretory system. Vitamin B9 aids in one of the most important functions of the body, which includes everything from the formation of red blood cells to the production of vital energy. Besides that, vitamin B9 also provides health benefits such as creating a defensive barrier from cancer, stroke, heart diseases, and birth anomalies. Other advantages include muscle building, hemoglobin formation, and also prevention from mental and emotional breakdowns. Vitamin B9 can be found naturally in asparagus, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and lentils. Enzymes in foods. Enzymes are vital for every cell in our body as they are organic, biological catalyst that starts, promote and speed up biochemical reactions. Metabolic enzymes in the blood break down the protein-based protection of virus, parasites, bacteria and fungi. They are cleansers that combat chronic inflammation, preventing most diseases including heart disease. Our body produces many enzymes, millions a day, but we still need a good supply of fresh enzymes from fresh food. When you eat a healthy wholesome diet with plenty of raw, fresh fruits and vegetables, you get a good variety of enzymes and antioxidants as well as fiber. Antioxidants are molecules that give off electrons that help to maintain the integrity of your cells. Antioxidants help to prevent cholesterol from oxidizing. In fact, oxidized cholesterol is the reason of fatality. Although oxidation is one of the normal bodily processes, it can be life-threatening if there's an overproduction of oxidized cholesterol. Why is that so? It's because unlike the other products of oxidation, oxidized cholesterol is commonly mistaken as bacteria by our natural immune system. Thus, your body will do whatever it takes to eliminate oxidized cholesterol from the body, causing inflammation of the arterial walls. As a result, It can lead to atherosclerosis or even heart diseases. There are many recognized antioxidants, but the one of the most well-known is vitamin E. Study after study has shown that vitamin E is a potent antioxidant that can help prevent and even treat free radical damage. Factory farming versus organic foods. Have you heard of the term factory farming? It's a modern-day term that refers to the non-traditional approach to farming businesses that focuses on keeping animals at high stocking densities. They're able to achieve this goal by incorporating modern technology to hasten animal growth, increase production outputs, and reduces the death rate of livestock. The modern society, especially business owners and investors, share the same opinion that factory farming is the way to go for modern farming. Factory farming was also regarded as one of the top innovations and believed to solve countless issues, providing high production output and lowering the cost. On the other hand, there are also some who are against it, claiming that factory farming brings more harm than good to both our health and environment. Animal activists also protest against animal cruelty practices in factory farming. So what is the truth? After years of close monitoring and extensive studies in the agriculture sector, it is found that most factory farming utilize poor quality ingredients and questionable processing methods. On the other hand, there's an organic way of farming. This term refers to the more natural, less toxic approach on how the agricultural products are grown and produced. For instance, organic crops must be grown without the use of modern agricultural chemicals such as GMOs, bioengineered genes, synthetic pesticides, sewage sludge-based, and petroleum-based fertilizers. Organic livestock must not be injected with growth hormones, antibiotics, or animal byproducts. Organic livestock must be grown with organic feed and given access to roam outdoors. Any less than that cannot be labeled as organic. Thus, organic agricultural products are far more nutritional and less toxic to our body. Consuming more organic food and less factory farmed food can lead to better health with more retained nutrients. Detox. The real story: our bodies, if given the raw materials needed, are very good at detoxing themselves. People who have a healthy, wholesome diet and refrains from indulging in too many processed foods, a small amount of processed food is not ideal, but the body can deal with it if not overloaded, will enjoy renewed energy and heart health. Meditative cures, reflexology and mindfulness. Psychological risk factors including anxiety and depression are clearly factors that can have a substantial effect on the heart. Stress can affect and increase the risk factors for heart disease and high blood pressure, BP, especially if coupled with physical inactivity and a person being overweight. Based on the latest clinical findings, it is found that meditation can drastically reduce the risk of heart diseases, stroke, and even death by approximately 50%. They found that deep breathing and acute relaxation can be more effective than any latest super drugs to prevent or even cure heart diseases. The ultimate goal of meditation is to find balance within our body. Although this may sound intangible and hard to grasp by the majority of our society today, meditation has been proven to balance out our biomarkers in the body. These biomarkers are also known as hormones and neurotransmitter. When you're experiencing stress or pain from any part of the body, it's normally due to the hormonal changes and neurotransmitter imbalance. A powerful cure for this situation is meditation. This practice helped countless of patients to regulate their biomarkers. Why is meditation so powerful? The secret lies in the practice of mindfulness. Mindfulness is a term that refers to being able to focus your awareness on the present moment and everything around you, both internally and externally. One of the keys of mindfulness is to always be at the present moment. Being present to your thoughts, emotions, and behaviors without judging them. The practice of non-judgment is the essence of staying truly calm and present. The benefits of mindfulness are endless. Studies have demonstrated that people who practice mindfulness regularly are more likely to live longer, have healthier hearts, stronger immune system, and unlikely to be obese. Another alternative therapy for heart health is reflexology. This method appeals to those who seek for non-invasive therapy. In fact, some people might even find reflexology to be rather relaxing and therapeutic. It's not necessary to visit the reflexology centers to reap the benefits, as you can easily apply these self-relaxing techniques yourself at any time on your hands and feet, provided that you know how to do it properly. Reflexology helps to maintain the balance of the mind and body by keeping them in a homeostasis state, so that the body can function optimally. By applying pressure at certain pressure points of the body, trained reflexologists are able to fix the malfunctioned body and put your body in the natural equilibrium state. Applying pressure at certain pressure points are able to stimulate your muscles, tissues, and even cells of any parts of your body. These pressure points are also known as reflexes on the hands and feet. Different pressure points affect different parts of the body. In order to relax and invigorate the myocardial muscles, the pressure points are located on the reflexes on your feet, which also indirectly stimulates the colon and pituitary gland. Superfoods for heart health. There are a lot of foods that have the properties to dramatically help with heart health problems, mainly because they are very rich sources of the nutrients and compounds that naturally purify arteries, cleanse and remove inflammation, as well as boost the immune system. Avocados are very high in healthy fats, and if eaten regularly, their compounds are able to normalize and stabilize blood cholesterol levels, maintain clear arteries and eliminate clots. Asparagus has been found to be a very effective blood cleanser. It is able to reduce blood pressure and slow the forming of blood clots. It is loaded with vitamins B1, B2, C, E and K. Pomegranates have an impressive array of antioxidants that help to protect artery membranes. They also promote the production of nitric oxide that allows a person's blood to flow more freely through their blood vessels. Turmeric reduces inflammation and the hardening of the arteries, as well as helping to keep them clear and reduce blood clots. Persimmon is a very good source of polyphenols and antioxidants that both help to reduce bad cholesterol, LDL, and triglycerides. They also help to normalize blood pressure and cleanse the arteries. Spirulina helps to regulate blood fat levels, normalizes lipid levels, and contains necessary essential amino acids, which help to improve the immune system. Cinnamon is able to decrease harmful cholesterol levels and clean plaque, so it is unable to accumulate in the arteries and blood vessels. Broccoli helps to prevent calcium buildup in arteries and helps to reduce blood pressure and normalize cholesterol levels. Cranberries are thought to decrease the risk of developing heart disease in most people by up to 40%. They have a high antioxidant content, which helps to increase HDL while reducing LDL levels. Green tea contains a large amount of catechins, which help to decelerate the absorption of cholesterol and improve blood lipid levels, as they help to clear obstructions from arteries. Green tea also helps with cardiovascular health and enhances a person's metabolism. Conclusion. Thank you for purchasing this guidebook. I hope you enjoy this book and benefit immensely from it. As a general rule, our body's overall health starts with taking care of our heart. If you are looking after your heart, then you will also be looking after the rest of your body. The decisions that you make regarding your diet and lifestyle will ultimately affect your heart health, your overall well-being. Not just that, your family will also be affected. If you're following a diet that consists of mainly processed foods, you're putting poisons into your body with empty carbohydrates and chemicals. Plus, if you're inactive in most parts of the day and live a sedentary lifestyle, you can expect to have major health issues at some point in your life, and you'll ultimately reduce your lifespan. On the other hand, if you have a healthy lifestyle, take sensible precautions on your food intake, and are active in physical exercises, then you can expect to live a long, healthy life, free of heart problems and many other chronic health issues that plague most people. This will allow you to enjoy your golden years in relatively good health.